Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at scanning documents using your iPhone. So every once in a while, I still get asked about scanners and what's the best document scanner or how to do document scans. And the thing is, for a lot of people, they've already moved on away from the old traditional flat pad or paper feed scanners to using simply their iPhone for scanning, because the camera in your iPhone is actually excellent quality. It takes close-up images really well and really sharply, and with the help of some apps you can actually scan much quicker and easier using your iPhone than you can with a flatbed scanner. Sometimes you can do things that aren't even possible, like for instance carrying your scanner to the library at your college may not be a possibility, but your iPhone's already with you. So I looked at a few apps. There are dozens of apps that do scanning. Here are a few that I like, mostly because the first two here, ScanBot and Cam Scanner, both have OCR or optical character recognition. So let's go and take a look at how they work. So ScanBot is pretty popular. There's the free app, and then you do in-app upgrades to add features like OCR. So I'm going to scan a new document, and once I hit that plus button, when it finds a document in camera range, it will automatically snap it, which is great. It speeds things up, or I can hit the snap button manually. It also means that you can take something kind of at a perspective, and you can see how, like, if I couldn't hover my phone directly over the image, it's going to grab it in perspective, and normally I would end up with an image that's got a kind of a trapezoidal look to it, but instead it's actually going to automatically correct it and adjust it so it looks like I took the picture flat. And I'm going to hit save, and it's going to process this. You can see it says they're processing, and it's going to go to 100%. I can select the title there, and instead of having a date and time, it's going to, let's see, I tap the title at the top, and it's going to come up with all these ideas for names, including using my location, using things that are nearby, and using things it finds in the document itself. So it found the word invoice, for instance, and it figured that's a good name for it. And now I've got that captured in there, and I can continue to go to other documents. I can also add pages to this current document. And that's how most of the scanning software works. So let's do it again. I'm going to do a receipt this time. And you can see it automatically took that picture and snapped it. And it's pretty good quality. There are adjustments I can make to it, and I can save it here. And it will add it to my library. I can organize in a lot of different ways. Let's look at it closer here. Let's look at the tap on the title there, and it's going to give me some things. So if I was actually maybe at like one of these places that it thinks are nearby, I could easily have tapped that and then tap the word receipt, and without ever having to type, I enter in the name. So it's really useful. And I go back, and I can see that receipt that I added. I can also go back and see that invoice I did earlier in the day. And notice I can select the text in it and copy it, because it's actually scanned the text in and converted it using OCR. So that's really useful as well. So you can do all this stuff with most of the scanning apps, the ones that support OCR. So let's go and take a look at another one now. So let's look at Cam Scanner, another popular scanning app. And this one has a free version that shows you how OCR works, but you need the paid version to actually use OCR to get the text out. So I'm going to scan in the back of my last book here, and it will take that. I'll hit the check mark there. It'll bring it in, and I can hit the OCR button at the bottom, and it will actually copy the text, and you can see it pastes it in there. And I need the premium version to go further with it. So you see lots of options there for you, and you can organize in this one as well. Now, of course, if you just want to take pictures of things and save them, you don't need any apps to do that. You can use the camera to do that as well. What these scanning apps bring to it is the ability to very easily add pages to a single document, to save them as PDFs, and also to straighten out pages if you're not taking a perfect straight down shot. Some other apps have scanning abilities in them. For instance, the Dropbox app, if you're a Dropbox user, you can add a scan, and it will do the same thing as you've seen in some of these other apps here. So I can scan in the back of my book and it will add it. So there's OCR available also for Dropbox users, but the cost is of being a business level user of Dropbox. And there's a ton of other ones. You can search in the in the App Store for scanners, for scanning, for OCR, and come up with all sorts of useful apps, whether you need to just quickly snap things like receipts and invoices, or to scan passages and books that you're doing research for in libraries and things like that. I once used one of these scanning apps, one called Genius Scan, to scan an entire family photo album that was available somewhere, and I was able to quickly go through the pages and scan about 50 pages of a family photo album that I only had a few minutes of access to, and I didn't have the ability to carefully scan each photo. So check those out and try to think a little differently about scanning now using your iPhone.